Hi, welcome to the chapter on using events. This is the final event.
It is the final event, basically, yeah.
So what are we going to talk about in this chapter?
Events.
What are events, then?
I don't know. What are they? I haven't gone through the chapter yet.
Well, we've been using events a lot through this through the whole course, haven't we?
So let's talk about... Well, that's true. If you look at the standard definition of an event would be an interrupt triggered in the system. A semaphore post would be an event in the system. Right. Things that, you know, looking at the execution graph, that basically helps you visualize all the events in the system.
So we've talked about one event triggering something to happen.
Right.
So what makes this a little bit different?
So this type of event is actually a service within TI-RTOS specifically. Okay. So let's go back and talk about semaphores for a second, Scott. Usually with semaphores, there's a one-to-one relationship between producer and consumer. In other words, the producer being, let's say, an interrupt says semaphore post, then you have a task that's waiting, pending on that semaphore to unblock and do its business. So that's a one producer, one consumer. Might there be in your system a need for multiple semaphores? Let's say if semaphore one is posted, or the combination of semaphore two and semaphore three, that set of combinations would unblock a task.
So you almost have like a logical expression would kick something off.
Yeah. Do you think you could write that code in C, Scott?
I could, but I'm kind of lazy. So it's nice if there's a service that does
so that. Enter in events. So yeah. Events are great because if you have multiple events in the system, meaning using the traditional terminology, if you had interrupt one and interrupt two and interrupt three, all were part of unblocking a task. Interrupt one could post an event. Mm-hmm. Interrupt two could post an event. Interrupt three could post an event. And the task could unblock on a logical combination of those events occurring in the system, be it an OR relationship or an AND relationship.
So it really is kind of a nice additional feature, being able to use multiple events in that way.
With events in the system, there are not a whole lot of combinations of things that happen in a system that cannot be processed by an event.
Well, let's go ahead and get to it.
Okay.
Okay, so welcome to the last chapter of the workshop, the fundamentals for TI-RTOS, chapter 12, using events. So what's the goal of this chapter? Well, we're going to learn how to use the events module to unblock a task and blink an LED. And so we have to investigate what is the events module, what problem is it trying to solve? How do we create events to unblock a task? And then under the hood, how do we use events with other signaling mechanisms like semaphores? So what's the lab goal? What we're going to do is we're going to take the previous lab, still using the clock function, and we're going to create an event object that in the clock function, every quarter second, we're going to post one event. And we haven't talked about what that is yet, but you'll understand that as we go through the chapter. And every other quarter second, we're going to post another event. If both events are true over there in task one function, then we're going to unblock that task and toggle the LED. So we need to go investigate some things about what are these events and how do they work, where do they come from, how do we create them and use them. So the outline for this chapter is we're going to spend a little bit of time talking about events. Scott, we've heard that interrupts are events. We've heard that there are BIOS events.
Use that term a lot.
We use that term a lot. So we're going to generically describe what it is and then specifically describe what it is. Next, we'll talk about how would you pend on multiple semaphores. We've talked about semaphores being a one-to-one relationship. You have a producer and a consumer. So what I'm talking about is you have multiple producers and one consumer. How do you build the logic that would unblock based upon a logical combination of that semaphore or this semaphore being posted. Yeah. Now I'm going to test your C skills a little bit, Scott.
Okay.
Next up, we'll talk about how do you create events and use events. And then a slightly advanced topic we're going to keep in this chapter is it possible that there is something that happens, like an interrupt goes off, and that event in the system is used for two things. One is you want to post a semaphore to unblock a task, but this is also something that happens that could be used as one of the three or four events to unblock another task. How do you do that? So we're going to talk about how to handle that. Then we'll finish up, like we always do, with a lab where you're going to be able to go in there and code, create events, use events to unblock a task that blinks an LED.